الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله وأسكى صلوات الله وتسليماته على من أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين وحجة على الناس أجمعين وعلى آله الطيبين وصحبه الغر الميامين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Secondly, allow me to say that Fajrul Islam is a brilliant initiative, and we must pray and make dua to the Almighty Allah that Fajrul Islam will continue to grow and gain more momentum inshaAllah. It is all of our obligation to support Fajrul Islam. Thirdly, allow me to divert slightly to Sheikh Sulaiman Salama. I must tell you the story of Sheikh Sulaiman. And with his kind permission, I think I am the only person that can tell that story. I don't think anybody else in Patreon can tell that story. I remember Sheikh Sulaiman from the day he arrived in South Africa. I remember him from the day that he arrived in South Africa. And when I listened to this man's broad vision and what he wanted to do, I thought for myself, what does an Egyptian brother want to do here in South Africa? But Sheikh Sulaiman has proven indeed that he persevered. His first few weeks in South Africa was not very comfortable. There was lots of discomfort when he arrived in South Africa. If I have to show you where Sheikh Sulaiman lived when he came to South Africa, you will have a shock if you should know where the Sheikh lived the first month when he came to South Africa. I went to meet him in that humble house and I gave him my support. وَإِنَّمَا الْإِخْلَاسُ يُعْرَفُ مِنَ الْبَعِيدِ. And sincerity you can see from a distance. And therefore, لهذا الدين ولهذه الأمة هيأ الله رجالا. Allah prepared for this ummah رجال. Men who understand that indeed إِنَّ بَعْدَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. Men who understand that indeed we have the responsibility, it is irrelevant whether the stage is decorated. Today, after 15 years, there is a beautiful stage. Many personalities are sitting here. The stage is decorated. But I remember the day we have seen the future of Islam for the last 45 minutes. Allow me to quote a very shocking example. 3-4 years ago, we had a visitor from the Gaza, Ahmed Al-Kurdi. He was the mayor of an area in Gaza called Deir Balah. Ra'is Baladiyya in Deir Balah. He spent 10 days with me. When we passed the area of Bukuletu, I was driving the car and Ahmed Al-Kurdi grabbed my hand like this. And the shanties of Bukuletu, he asked me the question, Sheikh Hassan, ماذا هذه الزنكات والبوخات? What is these zinc houses and these shanties that I see here? So I answered, and I told him, these are of the indigenous people of South Africa who live here. He asked me, فَمَاذَا تَفْعَلُونَ أَنْ هَذِهِ الْمُصِيبَةِ. What are you people doing about this? So I, like a smart Johnny, explained to him what the government is doing, or what the government is supposed to do. قَالَ لِي أَنَا لَا أَسْأَلُكَ أَنِ الْحُكُومَةِ أَنَا أَسْأَلُكَ مَاذَا تَفْعَلُونَ أَنْتُمُ الْمُسْلِمُونَ أَنَا هَذِهِ الْقَضِيَةِ. I'm asking you, what are the Muslims doing about this? Because everybody has questions about the government. In Nabal Islam, Islam can function without the government. Risalatul Islam can function without the government. Risalatul Islam functions fi kharij al-sijn wa fi dakhil al-sijn. Risala of Islam functions under any circumstances. So he says, what are you people doing about this? And yes, many thoughts went through my mind. But he left me with a very scary message. And he said, إِنَّنِي أُوْسِيكَ بِكُلِّ الْإِحْتِمَامِ بِهَاُلَاءِ السُّكَّانِ. I advise you to take all the very important concern around the indigenous people, because إِنَّنِي رَأَيْتُ فِي بَلَدِكُمُ الْجَمَالِ. I have seen beauty. I have seen Uhuwa. I've seen beautiful masajid. I've seen beautiful homes. I've seen the beautiful manadir al-tabi'iyya, the natural beauty of Cape Town. لَكِنَّنِي رَأَيْتُ فِي نَفْسِ الْوَقْتِ فِي نَفْسِ الْوَقْتِ لَقَدْ رَأَيْتُ إِنْفِجَارًا فِي بَلَدِكُمْ وَإِنَّ هَذِهِ الْحُرِّيَّةِ لَنْ تَدُومَ عَلَيْكُمْ. See, at the same time, I have seen a possible explosion coming from your country, and this freedom that you have will not last forever if you do not exercise your amana to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to conclude with another example to reinforce why our contribution, our support, our priority to support Fajrul Islam and to take the message of Islam to the indigenous people. Only recently again, I read the last speech of Sheikh Abu Hassan Ali al-Nadwi in Burma. The last speech of Sheikh Abu Hassan al-Nadwi in Burma, when he spoke to the Muslims in Burma and he told them, if you are not going to take care of this freedom that you have here, and he told the business people, he said, particularly I talk to the Muslims who came from Gujarat and from Surat, by name he calls it. Moulana Ali Adam, his testimony, he lived for 9 years with Sheikh Abu Hassan Ali Nadwi. كان في بيت Sheikh Abu Hassan Ali Nadwi. So the Sheikh invoked the ayah, وَلَا تُلْقُوا بِأَيْدِيكُمْ إِلَى التَّحْلُكَ. Do not cast your hands into destruction. He told the Muslim community in Burma, Allah did not only send you here for business. He sent you to the jungles of Burma so that you can bring the message of Islam. If you're not going to take the message of Islam to the Burmese people, the same people will exercise an inqilab, a revolution against the Muslims and against Islam. Believe me or not, without any exaggeration, almost 2 weeks after that, Burma collapsed. 2 weeks ago in Istanbul, I met a colleague of mine from Burma. I told Moulana Ali Adam, Moulana Muhammad Amin al-Nadwi, he now lives for many years in Imarat, and he sent me a lengthy email of the suffering of the Muslims in Burma. Let the lessons of Burma be a lesson for us here in South Africa. And therefore we have come to say thank you to Sheikh Sulaiman Salama, to Fajrul Islam, the elders of the township area, let me refer to it now, to thank them for allowing Fajrul Islam to function. To the business community, this is our obligation, we have to support it. Every cent is important for Fajrul Islam. To our brothers and our sisters, our special guests who came here, لَقَدْ نَوَرْتُمْ هَذِهِ الْمَدِينَةِ. You have indeed brought new nur and new light to this city here today. And to the students, we salute you. وَنَتَمَنَّ لَكُمْ كُلَّ الْخَيْرِ. شَكَرَ اللَّهُ جُهُودَكُمْ وَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ فِيكُمْ. وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ.